Okay, if we combine stress and strain in one diagram, this stage is actually a very small stage. Very small stage. Wherein we can notice that the relationship is what? Proportional. Straight line. Straight line relationship. Straight line, straight line. So they are what? Proportional. Like this. Straight line. Okay? So next, from ankram, going to the next stage, when we add additional load, when we increase the load, when we increase the load, we will have what? A simple beam like this, simple beam with increased load. So this is small, bigger load. Now this beam will experience what? Those are the cracks, crack portion of the beam. Let us indicate cracking. So crack portion will be on the tension side. So let us again draw the cross section of the beam BX. Let us draw BX. So with the same location and area for reinforcement. Now, since the lower portion already cracked, so we cannot expect that the same behavior or the same feeling. What is the good word for vibrare or feeling? Vibrare. So this concrete structure also has fillings. This swing, after which, so you increase. So this is the amount of the strain. If you increase the load, the amount of the strain will also increase. This will become bigger than this one. Become bigger and will look like this. So this is bigger than this one. And what about the stress? What about the stress? Also the stress will become bigger than this one. So this is bigger. However, it will crack up to the tensor. So what is it? From this point to this point, from this point to this point, you will have crack. Because tension side will have devoid of resistance due to concrete because of cracking, and therefore what is left behind is the participation of concrete purely for compression. This is compressive. So there is no what? There is no tension side participation. There is no tension side participation. But still the tension side, so tension, still there is again tension at the bottom and strain. Strain is physically visible. We can see strain. We cannot see the stress. We can feel the stress. We can feel the stress, but we cannot see. We can see the strain. We can see the strain. Like this, we can see. And even after the concrete cracks, we can still see how it elongates. How it moves at the lower portion. It moves, right? It elongates. If we talk about reinforcement, how much elongation this reinforcement had? So we have this
is about, is the amount of steel, elevation or strain. This one, now, this is day one, strain for the extreme fiber compared to this one. Okay? However, we will have the stress. Okay? We will have the stress for the stress for steel. We will have the stress for concrete. This is concrete, but this is for steel. So this is one. At the same level, same layer. Okay? Same level. This is the amount of now the participation for tension side is purely given by steel. So now this is the time wherein we can see that steel is all alone in resisting tension stress versus the concrete portion wherein all of the concrete part provides compressive resistance. Okay? So, and how about this? The link between ankrum and crown. Immediately, there is one. Curvature is actually represented by theta. If we recall, theory of structure. You can notice we have a diagram, force, moment, then curvature, then deflection. And, theory of structure. The curvature is related to. So this is how it looks like. So we have one deflection. Where is the curvature? So, where is the moment? The moment is provided for by P. So, the transfer from first stage to the next stage is immediately boundary of cracking. So the instant, the time that they are complete cracks is represented by this. It doesn't what? Increase the amount of load. The same amount of load, it does crack. The same amount of load. That's why it is horizontal. Same amount of load, but it has crack. Now, it is now increasing. We can increase and increase. Gradually increase up to very high level, very high level, up to the near maximum capacity before it will go to ultimate. So, very high level. So, this is very small amount of load compared to this maximum amount of this one compared to this one. Okay, that is the reason why we always use this model, because this is a useless modeling, because it is uneconomical. You have to make a beam with this amount of loading, of course, an economical, very small capacity, with the same cost, with the same cost. So we need this portion. We need this portion. Of course, we want to avoid ultimate. But we need this portion. That's why we usually utilize the modeling, which is what we call number two. The crack model. This is what we call the crack model, or the crack elastic stress model, or the crack elastic stress states.
wherein we have this drawing. We have this strain and stress diagram. Notice, strain is still the tension side concrete. Haven't strained, as I have demonstrated. There is no, almost there is no, almost or not, nothing in this area to the concrete resist the load. There is no resistance at all from the concrete, but there is one. There is steel resistance. Steel. Okay, so we have reinforcement resistance. So while in this case there is no feelings anymore. There is no feelings anymore. There is no participation whatsoever by the concrete side, only the reinforcement. Take note of this, and because we want to complete the stage,